when the beer's in the air.
Welcome to my CM20 final project. I'm Cody Vilkew, and let's go. Okay, our first project was to take some pictures, and it's literally we just went and took some pictures just to figure out how to use the camera, ISO settings, and aperture, your shutter speed. We had to learn all that. Then once we learned that, we went on to a photo project theme, which we had to actually take certain types of pictures, like black and white. We had to have different scenic views and so forth, you know.
I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the tie that binds, because you're mine. I walk the line. I find it very, very easy to be true. I find myself alone when each day's through. Yes, I'll admit that I'm a fool for you, because you're mine. I walk the line. As sure as night is dark and day is light, I keep you on my mind both day and night. And happiness I've known proves that it's right, because you're mine. I walk the line. You've got a way to keep me on your...
Then we kind of just stopped taking pictures, which was my favorite part of the whole course. I love taking pictures. And we moved on to, like, Photoshop and photorealism and such. And the first thing we did was stop sign, and we made a picture of a stop sign in Photoshop.
You give me cause for love that I can't hide. For you I know I'd even try to turn the tide.
Then we move to wood texture, which you've made a piece of wood.
Because you're mine, I walk the line.
Chain brush, you had to make a brush that painted a chain onto somebody. Paper towel, you had to make a paper towel roll.
I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide open.
The bottle, I didn't like this one. It kind of sucked. It's hard to do. But I had to make a bottle, so I did.
And all the time, I keep the ends out for the tie that binds. Because you're mine, I walk the line.
Then we moved on to videos. And videos were tough, really. We had to do a beam effect. We had to teleport somewhere from someplace and make it look like we moved to another place. Thank you. clone I didn't do because I didn't have time and I didn't want to. And I did student choice and I just used my ELA final project, did some editing to it, handed it in.
Didn't think very much of my doings, and for that I would like to apologize to them, but I had to do what I had to do.
So that's why you helped him? Because?
I felt it was my civic duty to help a man in need.
Okay. So what happened that night outside the prison?
Well, there were a group, I had heard there was a group of men attempting a lynch on top of Robinson. So I got a light, got a chair, got a book, and stood guard, because I would not allow Tom Robinson to be killed.
So after that night, did you have high hopes in like the court ruling and such?
Well, there were points during the trial where I thought there was hope for my case, but I had to remember that it was a black man's word against a white man's. And though they were lower class whites, they were still white, and that always wins over black people.
So do you think that's why Tom Robinson died?
I believe so, yeah.
Racism? Okay. And now, what do you think about Bob Ewell's death?
I believe that every man gets what's coming to him, just as though he did. And though it will be a tragedy for his family, he got what he deserved.
So, who murdered him? Who grabbed him?
I think whatever happened, happened, and that is not information I have the authority to disclose.
Alright, unfortunately that's all the time we have for tonight. I'd like to thank Atticus Finch for having come to